morning about an upcoming program of recruitment of local defense personnel nationwide, which will start Monday 23rd August this year and will run up to the 16th of September this year, 2021. We have already put out a statement, press statement. Yesterday was sent by the deputy, by the defense spokesperson. I believe some of you have already seen it and used it. I've at least also seen the new vision today, and Wukede put out the advertisement, a detailed one. But I'm here because we got this opportunity to come and re-emphasize a few things about this exercise. Like I said, the exercise is in line with the constitutional mandate of the Minister of Defense and the UPDF, which is to preserve and defend the territorial integrity of Uganda. And in this, of course, we do work with auxiliary forces, as has always been before, like in other operations against the LRA, against the Allied Democratic Forces, even in the central Uganda here where we had some security challenges. Auxiliary forces have always been part and parcel of the Uganda People's Defense Forces operations. So this time round, we're also going to recruit up to 10,000 members of the local defense personnel countrywide. I said the program will run from 23rd of August up to 16th of September. This time round, because of the COVID-19 pandemic situation and the attendant standard operating procedures as stipulated by the Ministry of Health, we shall change the modus operandi of conducting this recruitment exercise. So we shall require any interested candidates to make handwritten applications to the Chief of Defense Forces and submit them to their respective resident district commissioners between 23rd to 27th of August this year. In the applications, they will be expected to indicate their nationality, age, marital status, education qualifications, and we shall require them to submit copies of their national identity cards and all their academic credentials. Then, our teams will go and collect these application forms from the respective districts, verify them, and then we shall produce short lists of candidates who will be required now to turn up at different recruitment centers, which I'm going to read out shortly. So, the names of the successful candidates who will be shortlisted will again be sent back to the district headquarters, same offices of the resident district commissioners, between 2nd and 16th of September. Then after that, all those shortlisted candidates will report to different recruitment centers across the country for the final recruitment exercise. Among the criteria that we really require for these people to fulfill, one, of course, is citizenship. The Constitution of the Republic of Uganda that mandates all operations of UPDF stipulates that all people to serve in the armed forces will be citizens of Uganda. Therefore, citizenship is a must that they must be Ugandan. The age we are considering between the age of 18 and 29 for both male and female applicants. Third, about the medical condition of these applicants, all must be healthy and physically fit and ready to undergo medical and physical body checkups. And they will be subjected to endurance tests to confirm their health and physical fitness. Education standard, we shall entertain applicants with a minimum formal education of Uganda Certificate of Education or Senior 4 completed at least in the last 3 years. That I mean, now this is 2021, so 2020, 2019, 2018. We require them also to have confirmation of good conduct and no criminal record, and this will be confirmed by the local council, one chairpersons, and the Gombo internal security officers. We believe these officers know their citizens very well, and we shall request them to give them letters of recommendation to confirm their good conduct and that they do not have any criminal record. We do not want to take people who are trying to run away from the law and think they will find refuge in our institution. I will now very quickly read out the recruitment centers and some of the dates, which will start from 7th of September. The districts of Bukomansimbi, Gomba, Kalangala will all come to the Armored Brigade headquarters in Masaka on the 7th of September 2021. But these will be the people that will have been shortlisted from the many applicants. Now, on 8th of September, same year, at the same location of Armored Brigade headquarters in Masaka, we shall have applicants from Kalungu, Rakai, and Luengo districts. Then on 9th of September, applicants from Butambala, Shotera, Liantonde will all come to Armored Brigade headquarters in Masaka. Then on 10th of September, we shall have applicants from the district of Zimbabwe. Now, here in the 1st Division headquarters, which is Kakiri, the exercise will run from 7th up to 14th of September, and they will be receiving applicants from the districts of Kasanda, Mityana, Mubende, Kiboga, Kyankwanzi, Mpigi, Luwero, Nakaseke, Kampala, and Wakiso. We shall also have a team that will be in Masindi, which is the headquarters of the Field Artillery Division, between again 7th up to 10th of September, to verify and recruit applicants who will be shortlisted from the districts of Nakasongola, Masindi, Hoima, Ulisa, Kibale, Kakumiro, Kagadi, Chikube, and Kiryandongo. Then there will be a team also in Jinja, which will be based at the Kimaka airstrip in Jinja, between again 7th and 12th of September. These ones will handle applicants from the districts of Mukono, Buikwe, Kayunga, Buvuma, Jinja, Namayingo, Mayuge, Kaliro, Buyende, Kamuli, Namutumba, Iganga, Luka, Bujiri, and Bugweri. Now, further, we shall have a team in Moroto, based at the 3rd Division headquarters, which is in Moroto Barracks, between 7th and 9th of September, to attend to applicants from the districts of Karenga, Kabong, Kotido, Abim, Moroto, Napak, Nakapiripirit, Nabilatuk and Amudat. Another team will be based in Imbale at Bugema Barracks between also 7th and 13th of September to attend to applicants from the districts of Bukwo, Kapchorwa, Queen, Bulambuli, Mbale, Sironko, Bududa, Butareja, Manafa, Namisindwa, Ukedea, Ngora, Kumi, Soroti, Serere, Katakwi, and Kapela Biong, also Amuria, Kabera Maido, Tororo, Busia, Palisa, Butebo, Budaka, and Chibuku. So all these will be attended to from Bugema Barracks in Mbale. Then we shall have a team in West Nile based at the 409 Brigade headquarters in Bondo between also 7th and the 10th of September to attend to applicants from the districts of Arua, Madiokolo, Yumbe, Maracha, Ajumani, Moyo, Obongi, Koboko, Nebi, Pakwach, and finally Zombo. For the districts of Acholi sub-region, we shall have a team based at the 4th Division headquarters in Gul Barracks between 7th and 8th of September, and they will attend to applicants from the districts of Gulu, Omoro, Nuoya, and Amuru. For the districts under 5 Division Area of Responsibility, we shall have a team based at Acholi P, which is the 5 Division headquarters, that is in Pade district, between 7th and 10th of September to attend to applicants from the districts of Kitgum, Lamo, Pade, Agago, Lira, Dokolo, Aleptong, Otuke, Amolatar, Apach, Kwania, Oyam, and Kole. Coming to Ankole sub-region, we shall have a team based at Kacheka Stadium in Imbarara between the 7th also up to 9th of September to receive and verify applicants from Mobushenyi, Uhweju, Mitoma, Rubirizi, Mbarara, Shema, Isinjiro, Ibanda, Ruampara, Kirhura, and Kazo districts. We shall also have a team based in Intungamo at our 409 Brigade headquarters at Irenga in Intungamo district between 7th and 9th to attend to applicants from the districts of Kabale, Rubanda, Ruchiga, Kisoro, Intungamo, Rukunjiri, and Kanungu. Finally, the last team will be at Boma Grounds in Fort Portal between 7th and 11th September 2021 to handle applicants from the districts of Kasese, Bundibugyo, Toroko, Kabarole, Bunyangabu, Kamwenge, Kitagwenda, Kienjojo, and Chegegwa. So this is how the exercise will run, and we shall continue, of course, reminding these applicants, and like I said, the advertisements have already started running in the print media. We thank you very much for giving us space, for those who have done it. We shall continue making these announcements on all available media for the success of the exercise. Because it is the first time we are doing it this way, we thought that we should come and clarify on some of these things. We cannot have very many people turn up at district headquarters like we used to do previously, understandably because of the situation of the COVID-19 pandemic. That's why applications will be the method now. People apply, we shortlist, then only the shortlisted can come at those different recruitment centers I've talked about. I think I've made myself clear, unless there are any requests for clarifications.
Thank you very much, sir. beg you give us a bite in Uganda briefly, and then now we have permission.
But this is too lengthy to read in Uganda.
No, not going to read this.
Yeah, the summary. Yeah, summit. Yeah. I think so. Yes. Yeah, that's what I wanted to say, because there are too many. Okay. Atuze wano okutegeeza gwanga genda kubera ko ne program eyokuwandisa abaserikale aba local defense personnel abakola nafa maje aga UPDF. Program eno eri mateeka nga semateeka bwetugamba okuwandisa abantu betunakolanga nabo mu maje. Program egenda kutandika nga 23 kuno mwezi ogw'omunaana, inegendera ddala paka enaku 16 ez'omwezi ogw'omwenda guno omwaka. Olw'embeera ya COVID-19 erwokati fena gye tutegeera, tugenda kukyusaamu mu nkola gye tugenda okuwandiisa abantu bano. Edda twagamba nga abantu basobole okujja ku districts bwe tubawandiikira, naye kati tugenda kusaba bonna abaagadde babandyagadde okwetanira mu programu eno bawandike ebbaluwa application letters nga baziwandiikira omukulu omuduumizi mukulu wa Major Chief of Defense Forces. Ebbaluwa ezo basaana ziwandiika nga ziraga nationality yaabwe, emyaka, bye basoma. Ebbaluwa ezo zirina okubeerako National ID oba endagamuntu, kopi yaayo ne kopi ez'ebiwandiiko eby'amasomero mwe basomera. Zino ebbaluwa zaakutwalibwa mu office za Resident Evil Commissioner mu buli district kuva nga 23 mpaka 27 guno omwezi ogw'omunaana. Oluvannyuma tulina ttiimu zaffe ez'amagye zijagenda zikunganye ebbaluwa zino bazirete kutandika enaku 2 mpaka 16 nga basunsulamu mu bantu abawandiisa ebbaluwa, then tusobole okujjamu bye tulaba nti tusobola okuwandiisa mu program eno. Ebyetaagibwa mu bufunzafunze, twagala abantu bano bonna babeere nga bana Uganda nga ba myaka wakati w'emyaka 18 na 29 nga basajja oba bakazi. Twetaaga nga babeere n'obulamu obulungi nga si balwadde, kubanga tugendera bakebera tulabe nti basobola okusobola training yaffe n'okukola naffe. Twagala abasomye wakiri paka siniya ey'okuna mu myaka 3 egy'emabega, naye twagalako n'abo abalinamu certificates ez'obukugu especially mu mirimu egy'engalo ngaba abazimbi, ngaba pulamba, ngaba kapenta, bwe batyo ababazzi, kubanga bana nabo tubeetaaga nnyo mu programu eno. Bano abantu twagala babeere n'ebbaluwa eziva mu ba LC1 chairpersons baabwe ne ba GISO Gombole Internal Security Officer, ebbaluwa eziraga nti bano bantu balungi, tebalina misango, ate si bantu abasobola okujja ate ne tebakwasa omulimu guno ne batubeera ab'obulabe. So zino ebbaluwa tubatusaba aba LC n'aba GISO kubanga tukakasa nti bano abantu baba babamanyi mu byalo byabwe gye bava, basobole okutuwandiikira ebbaluwa nga bakakasa nti bantu balungi babamanyi, n'olwekyo baba recommending okujja okukola naffe. Program tugenda kubeera ne centers nyingi betubanga tumaze okusunsulamu. Tugenda kubeera ne center e Masaka Armored Brigade Headquarter, tugenda kubeera ne center Kachiri First Division Headquarter Barracks, Tukenda kubera ne center field artillery division headquarters e Masindi endaleja kubera Jinja Tembale ja kubera ko ne center Bondo district ya Arua ja kubera kenda la ne Guru ku barracks ya 4th division ne bechibinje chokuna endaleja kubera ku chibinje chokutano ekitwa Acholi P district ya Pade tugenda kubera ko ne Kacheka stadium Mbarara irenga barracks intungamo a center isemba ya kubera nga Fort Poto Boma Grounds zino center zienda kubanga zisusula mubali betunaba shortlistings betunamaruba over shortlisting nga amanya tugazayo ku districts then abo bebana sobolo kuja ku center zino azenjogedeko wakati wenda ku musanvu ne 11 za September omwezi ogwomwenda program tugenda kubiranga era tukola programs ku radio ne ku TV ezimune zimu okulaba nti ebintu bino abantu babitegeera bulungi abandi agade okujja ne batwegatako mu program eno ya local defense personnel program wetu wegenda okutambula twaniriza abantu bonna abalaba nti basobola okwetanya mu programu eno bagoberere bino bye twogeddeko kubanga baddemu enkyukakyuka kino tubadde tetukikolanga ekyokugamba nti abantu basobola okuwandiika bajjanga bonna ku districts nesobola okuwandiikirawo naye kati olw'embeera eriwo tekigenda kusoboka kyovaolaba twagala tubeere nga tubinyonyola bulungi ebintu bino babitegeere obaoliawo omuntu aseta missinga lwakubanga information touch kunye bulungi mwe bali take questions agange
yes sir
bade baza na bogeti
damu bogeti
okay Lieutenant Colonel Ronald Kakurungo deputy defense spokesperson
we have interested on the four questions but basically stick on LDU yes dear.
Yes, sir. The name, sir. Jeff. UTV. New Vision. Yes. Yes. I first take many and answer at once. Here. Bribery. Name again. Benedict. CTV. Or the regional papers. Bukid. Yes, sir.
You said that you will be recruiting members of Kenya for some time. Why are you recruiting directly in the UPDF? Thank you. Lastly, Ivan. Ivan, how are you? I work for UBC.
Yes, Ivan.
Respond to this. Yes,
sir. Thank you very much for your questions. I'll answer them in the order they have been asked, starting with Jeff. Yes, good one. Integrity is high on our agenda in this exercise, as has always been before. Presentation of any forged documents, especially academic documents or identity cards, is a criminal offense. So we warn any people who may think that they can fraudulently join the forces, that once found out, even if you have already been recruited, you will be removed and prosecuted according to the laws of the country. Bribery. Yes, there have always been unscrupulous people who come and try to say, see me, I'm going to connect you, and because the competition is high, pay me some money, and they know those officers who recruit. And we're also sounding a warning to all this, that should we find them, they'll still be arrested and prosecuted according to the law. But also, to warn the applicants that you do not have to pay anybody any money to join the defense forces, not at all. You do not ask for any money. You just have to come with these requirements like I've read them, and if you qualify, you'll be recruited. You don't have to pay anybody. So please do not fall prey to any of these wrong characters who want to take advantage of innocent Ugandans who want to come and genuinely serve their country. Thank you. Bernadette, why LDUs now? No, it's not now. Like I said, we have always worked with the LDUs. The technical word is auxiliary forces. We have regular forces, auxiliary forces, and reserve forces. So the LDUs fall under auxiliary forces. Like I said, we have always worked with them. We worked with them against during operations against the Lord's Resistance Army in northern Uganda and in the Teso sub-region, against Allied Democratic Forces in western Uganda. Even in Karamoja disarmament operations, they have been working with us. So it's not that we are starting the program afresh. We have always worked with them. The only difference is that we have been recruiting on case basis as required, not nationwide. But this time we're doing it nationwide. Otherwise, they've always been there. They've always been there. You asked me to make a quick comment about a general purpose, but maybe let me first finish the questions about the LDs and I'll address that separately. Isma, you say, why are we not recruiting UPDF directly, but local defense personnel? Local defense personnel, like I said, are members of the auxiliary forces. It depends on the need at a particular time. However, with time, when we find that we have a requirement for the regular forces, sometimes we actually go to these same auxiliary forces and screen from amongst those ones and make them part of the regular forces. One, it is cheaper, and you're dealing with people who have already received some training, so you do not have to look for people afresh. And we have already seen who can work in the regular forces and who may not work. So that does not take away the recruitments for the regular forces. But I'm saying we recruit depending on the requirement at the moment. So this time round, we require more of the local defense personnel. But some of these can, in fact, later be integrated in the regular forces, whenever such a requirement may be there. Ivan, LDUs in the spotlight for human rights violations, misuse of weapons. I do not want to say bluntly, putting a blanket statement, that LDUs have been violating human rights, like you're putting it. Though it is true we have had some isolated cases of individuals, but over and above, these young men and women have been doing a tremendous job in supporting the Uganda People's Defense Forces in their operations. Yes, being a big force, and that's why sometimes we insist on the record of these people, character. And this way, again, I request the leaders whom we ask to recommend these people, local council chairpersons, and internal security officers, that these are the sub-counties. This is how we can guard against individuals who may come and have completely other intentions. But over and above, I want to say that we cannot say all the LDUs have been a a problem in terms of violation of human rights? No. In fact, even some of the members of the regional forces, as individuals, have made some mistakes. And as policy of the military, these ones, such mistakes involving misuse of weapons, and subject them to the due process of the law. And these, many of you have always been seeing them in our courts martial, disciplinary committees. So we have zero tolerance to any indiscipline or violation of human rights. But over and above, even if I can, for example, here in Kampala Metropolitan, where we had a problem and we got a requirement from the commander-in-chief to recruit LDUs, they turned around the situation. Remember situations of murders, robberies. They did a good job, and they are still doing a good job, especially in returning sanity in the Kampala Metropolitan area. So case by case, yes, they could be there, but we always deal with them according to the law as established. Someone asked me to comment quickly about the late General Pecos Kutesa. Yes, as you all have already known, Lieutenant General Pecos Kutesa retired, passed on Tuesday this week while on admission in New Delhi, India, Max Hospital in India. It's very unfortunate. Today, his remains will be returned. In the next few minutes, we expect the aircraft bearing the remains of late General Pecos to arrive at Entebbe International Airport. We shall have a service, a requiem service, at his home in Vuziga tomorrow, starting at 10. And thereafter, we shall proceed to his ancestral home in Kabula, which is the Lyantonde district, where tomorrow again there will be another requiem service at that home, and then a vigil. The burial will be on Sunday. Sunday is the 22nd, starting at 10 a.m. So far, that is the program, and it is sad that he just passed on when he had had a very illustrious career spanning about 40 years. He joined the forces in 1979. He had done a very good job, several contributions to the country. Up to the time of his retirement, he was the commander of the UPDF Center for Doctrine, Development and Synthesization. He superintended over very good work in terms of producing the defense doctrine for Uganda, and also the UPDF establishment was all under his docket. By the time of his retirement, he had embarked on establishing the military museum, and that project had also gone a very long way because of his commitment to documenting our history as a country. So we shall indeed miss him as a force, but also as a country, considering his spirit of nationalism, patriotism, commitment to service, that we had benefited from him as a country, spanning over that long period of uninterrupted service of about 40 years. So we pray that may the Almighty God rest the soul of the late General Pecos Kutesa in eternal peace. Thank you. All this one. We have all that time. Binge. Yes,
sir.
Programu eno eyo kuandisa abasirikale aba local defense personnel subira kuandisa abantu mutwalo gumu mugwanga lyonna ye target number je tulina betusobola okutendeka ku budde bwe kuchokungana kulumbeerwa omugenzi of course tuba tugoberera amateeka agamins of health kubya COVID-19 tubate tukiriza abantu bangi okujja kukungubagana ffe kubanga era tukimanyi abadde n'emikwano mingi ab'oluganda bangi naye olw'embeera bonna ababa tebasobola kujja wadde wano mu maka ge Buziga oba wetunaamutwala okumuziika e Kabula ja kuba tusaba just abantu batono aba family n'abakulu abatonotono mu government no mu maje and very close family members. Where did they rate them again? Yeah, here. Okay. Tukubira omulanga bonna abagenda okujja kukola naffe mu programu eno ya LDU nti tetujja kukkiriza ebintu byonna ebijingirire ng'empapula ez'amasomero enjingirire oba endangamuntu buli anaagezaako okuleeta ebintu bino nga bijingire ne tumufuna ajja kukangavulwa ate ne tumutwala mu mbuga z'amateeka ng'ebiragiro bwe bigamba ne bw'oba olowooza nti osobola okutuyitako ku liiso olumwefu ne bwe tumaze okukuwandiika ne tukitegeera nti wakozesa empapula nga njingirire era tuba kujamu ne tukugoba ate ne tukuteeka mu mbuga z'amateeka nga amateeka bwe gagamba ag'eggwanga waliwo n'abantu sekinoomu gye buvuddeko abaali bagezaako okutandika okusaba ssente mu baana bano abaagala okujja okutwegatako abo bagamba nti abakulu abawandiisa babategeera bulungi nsimanyi enyiriri mpanvu nnyo tubaze okuwayo kasente babayambe bano abo tubakubira omulanga nti anaakigezaako ne tumufuna era naye waakukwatibwa ne tumutwala mu mbuga z'amateeka naye n'abo bennyini abaagala okujja okutwegatako okukola naffe tubakubira omulanga nti tosaana kusasula ssente yonna okujja mu programu eno ey'okwewandiisa mu local defense personnel requirements byetwogedde byokka bye twetaaga tetwetaaga muntu yenna okusasula ssente anywhere wadisimanyi wagiso oba wakiyamaani oba wa RDC oba mu maje tosaana kusasula ssente yonna. Programu y'aba LDU tetandise olwaleero twakola nabo mu bikwekweto eby'enjawulo nga mambuka g'eggwanga bwe twali tulina entalo na Lord's Resistance Army wano mu bitundu bya Teso era n'eno mu bugwanjuba bw'eggwanga bwe twabeera ne bikwekweto n'abayekera aba Allied Democratic Forces abantu bano tulidde tukola nabo era wano ne mu Kampala ndowooza abangi mbadde mubalabako bwe twafuna obuzibu nga mulimu ebibinja ebyali bisazeewo okuleeta okuleetamu akasasamalo mu kibuga muno nga batta abantu nga babba bakozesa eryanyi twawandiika aba LDU bano ate bakoze omulimu omulungi so far okulaba nti ebitundu bino byetukolera nabo obutebenkevu bukomawo na wala neka kando tuchabalina nga Karamoja nga Gulu nga Teso tuchabalina ne mu Kampala era mwebali tuongera ko bwongezi ku namba kubanga waliwo bwetaavu abantu bano waliwo abuziza nti lwaki tetuwandiikira ddala aba UPDF benyini ne tuwandiikamu ba local defense tewali kitugaana okuwandisa abantu bano kiri mu mateeka okukola nabo betuyita auxiliary forces obwetaavu obuliwo kati bwabo bwa abasirikale aba regular tebuliwo mu kaseera kano naye bwe babaddewo olumu era tuddamu mu bano bennyini aba LDU ne tusunsulamu ne tulaba oba mu olumu abasobola okujja ne bakola ate mu majja aga regular kino kituyambako okusavinga ku budde ne sente mu kifo ky'okuddayo ate mu byalo ne mulonda abantu abapya muyinza okugenda mu bano bennyini be mukoze nabo bategedde empisa bategedde engeri gye bakolamu ne tusunsulamu abo bennyini ne tusobola okuba yingiza amagye genyini aga regula era tuludde nga tukikola ade kaakano tusobola okuddamu ne tukikola kasita wabaddewo obwetaavu obw'okuwandiisa amagye genyini aga regular forces abantu bano aba LDU si kituufu nti beenyigira mu bikolobero eby'okutyoboola eddembe ly'abantu oba okukozesa eryanyi ekituufu kiri nti oyinza okusangayo omu ku omu omusekinoomu ng'akola ensobi naye ffe nga amagye oba ministry tulina amateeka amakakali ku bantu bwe bati omuntu omu bw'aba avuddeyo n'akola omusango n'azza omusango ekyo tekitegeeza nti ejje lyonna 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 wamu nti lye likoze ekizibu no oyo omuntu bwe tuba tumufunye nga bamutulangidde tubakangavula tubatwala mu mbuga z'amateeka ate zaffe muzimanyi salirawo mangu zi general court martial oba za division court martial oza bangi mbadde muzirabako tulina ne programs eziraba nti abantu bano tubeera tubasomesa ne tubategeeza emirimu gye basaana okugikola tulina ekitongole ekya Directorate of Human Rights mu UPDF gumu ku mirimu gyabwe gibeera okusomesa abantu bano n'okulaba nti babeera bakola bulungi nga tewali omu atuusaako abantu ate basaana okukuuma obulabe n'olwekyo tulina obukakafu nti bano abantu bagenda kukola bulungi era betulina over and above babadde bakola omulimu omulungi bonna nga wamu. I think I've answered all of them. Thank you.